While interfacing with the Parliamentary Committee on National Economy over the performance of the economy and state of indebtedness, the Minister of State for Finance, General Duties, Henry Musasizi, noted that the Russia-Ukraine war has got a direct effect on the national economy and is projected to slow down the GDP growth by between 0.5% to 1% in the financial year 2022-2023 on top of other factors.
Could potentially reduce the projected GDP growth by between 0.5 to 1 percentage points in financial year 2022-2023.
Musasizi says the war has hit the whole world, exacerbating global fuel prices, and it's expected to slow down global economic growth from 6.1% to 3.6%.
The recent global developments, especially war in the Russia and Ukraine, other global developments including the lockdown in China, and the increased global demand amidst disruptions in the global supply chains. These are expected to slow down global growth from 6.1% in 2021 to 3.6% in 2022 and 2023, respectively.
Me, I feel we haven't sat like a country to set priorities among priorities. We are really, like a lot of merrymaking. Somebody was talking of tighten the belts, mkekereze, endure, but it's not yet there.
In the same meeting, the government noted that Uganda's total public debt stock has increased by 15.4% in a space of 1 year and currently stands at 73.5 trillion shillings as per December 2021. Of these, 45.72 trillion shillings is external debt and domestic debt stands at 27.77 trillion shillings. This left MPs concerned and wondering how Uganda will come out of the debt trap.
The total public debt stock as at the end of December 2021 stood at US$20.7 billion, equivalent to Uganda shillings 73.5 trillion. External debt accounted for 62.2%, equivalent to USD $12.9 billion, and domestic debt accounted for 37.8%.
Sometimes I even shy away to call myself a member of the Committee of National Economy, because people see us mortgaging the country, see us over borrowing, and it is very hard to explain to them.
As Kenya draws near to the much-anticipated presidential elections in August, the government of Uganda has started plans to rehabilitate the central corridor of Dar es Salaam to Kampala trade route to shift away from the Mombasa route, which it is suspected will be at risk being affected by politics should violence escalate in Kenya after the elections.
From the previous experience, whereby the Kenyan elections have posed a situation of violence previously, and this has a direct impact in our supply chains because we use 75% of our imports come through the port of Mombasa. Any disruption affects us directly.
Musasizi reiterated the government's commitment to produce the necessary infrastructure, such as vessels to transport fuel on the lake from Tanzania to Uganda, to ensure that the 2007 crisis that followed the stormy Kibaki Odinga elections do not reoccur.
We have procured vessels which can be used to transport fuel through Mombasa port to Kampala, just in case, even when there is no political risk, we feel it is better management to have options, so that when the line of Kenya, the route of Kenya, is experiencing some challenges, we can have an option of using Tanzania.
However, committee members have asked the Ministry of Finance to make interventions available to rein over the escalating pump prices, which keep skyrocketing every day.
Surpluses and deficits. Probably, maybe the ministry could give us how much deficits were registered. Because the minister seems to tell us that we had surpluses with East Africa, the rest of Africa, and the European Union. But we registered deficits with Asia, Middle East, and the rest of other trading partners.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.